Gregory Jacobs, the charismatic, affable digital underground rapper producer who performed as Shock G and Humpty Hump, died Thursday at the age of 57. Jacobs' father confirmed the musician's death to TMZ, though a cause of death remains unknown. 34 years ago, almost to the day, we had a wild idea we can be a hip-hop band and take on the world. Through it all, the dream became a reality and the reality became a nightmare for some, Digital Underground's Chalkmaster J wrote on Instagram. And now he's awakened from the fame. Long live Shock G aka Humpty Hump, and rest in peace my brother Greg Jacobs. Hash Digital Underground. Over the course of 6 albums, most notably 1990's Sex Packets and 1991's Sons of the P, Digital Underground expanded on Parliament Funkadelic's bouncy, elastic funk and outlandish, occasionally goofy stage personas and costumes to become a singular hip-hop group. A Digital Underground show was like a vaudevillian variety show, Chalkmaster J told Rolling Stone in 2017. While the group went through numerous lineup changes over the years, Jacobs, who co-founded the collective, always remained at the center before disbanding the group in 2008. He assumed various identities, but none more famous than Humpty Hump, the fur-wearing braggadocious rapper whose Humpty dance remains a paragon of classic hip-hop more than 30 years later. A hip-hop renaissance man, Jacobs designed the artwork for many of Digital Underground's albums, as Rackadelic, and played drums and piano, the latter credited on albums as the Piano Man. He was just as instrumental behind the scenes, producing, and appearing on, Tupac Shakur's breakthrough song I Get Around and 1995's So Many Tears, among others, and bringing a young Shakur into Digital Underground. Months before the release of his debut album Tupaclips Now, Shakur made his mesmerizing debut on Digital Underground's same song. As detailed in a 2017 Rolling Stone article, Shakur worked as a roadie for the group while Jacobs and his manager shopped the rapper's demo. Digital Underground would give Tupac his first tour, alongside Big Daddy Kane, MC Light and Heavy D in 1990, his first released verse with same song and his first movie role in 1991's Nothing But Trouble. He was on TNT Records, with us, for 4 years, Jacobs told Rolling Stone. He was with Death Row for 9 months. So do the math.